obedient to their aunties, uncles, and their elders. They should be loving. They should be kind. And they should be hardworking. They should have respect for one another. They should be honest. They should cooperate with others and take their studies serious. We are graduating today into a higher responsibility. I advise my fellow private people who are graduating today to keep the flag flying by sharing the good morals we have been taught in this place. Take your studies serious and make that school LDGC and Nigeria proud of you. Once again, I thank the teachers, the head mistress, the preparator, the PTA chairman, and the school authority for all the effort they have put to bring us to this point. Once again, my name is Egan Kaimaro. Thank you.
Put your hands together for him. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'd like to bring to the stage a welcome song by the graduates. Put your hands together as they are marching to the stage. Clap for them. Children, clap for them. Clap for them. Thank you.
Let them shift forward.
The school choir should get ready. School choir, get prepared for your presentation. Put your hands together for them. Thank you. Thank you. Please permit me to bring to the stage the school choir, staff school FGDC Calabar. March down to the stage for your presentation. March down to the stage for your presentation. Martin department should get prepared for your drama. Get prepared for your drama after the school choir.
You smile and flip your head. You make me sing.
by the school choir. This would have been best. Thank you.
Selected peoples. Include or march your children to the stage, please.
That's her right there. Don't mind me, I think I do everything you get.
Take care, you should get prepared. Take care, get prepared for your presentation. It's like they are not ready. Please, if I don't call your class, don't stand up with your children. Please. down with your children, or else I will not call your class. Sit down with your children. Thank you, dear, thank you very much. Permit me to bring to the stage while we are still waiting for the drama. Permit me to bring to the stage. Please staff, stand by. These children that are walking up and down, stand by. Tell them to look for a place and sit down. Please look for a place and give them to settle down. If a child you're understanding, I'll get the seat from you. Look for a place and sit. Permit me to bring to the stage somebody that will present an article on the 10 ways to enhance a child's greatness. In the presence of is a psychologist, in the presence of Professor Miss Favour Bassi. Put your hands together for her. While we are still waiting for the drama people, put your hands together. 10 ways to enhance your child's greatness by the young professor. Put your hands together for her. You are not clapping. Children, clap. If it is talk, you can talk. Clap for her. Clap. Thank you.
Thank you very much. My name is Favour Victor Bassi. 10 ways to enhance your child's greatness. Children that grows up to be great and well-adjusted adults take a lot of hard work. Psychologists give 10 essential points to enhancing your child's greatness. They are number one. Parents should learn how to love. Your children need to know that you love them genuinely. They cannot read your mind, so tell them as often as you can that you do love them. Number two, care for your children. This is done by providing them with their basic needs, not their wants, which may be wrong desire. Adequate clothing, good food, and sound education are needs of your children. Number three, give your children attention. Don't be so strict that you have no time to play or even work with them. Make time to attend to them. Find out what happened to them at school. Look at their homework. Your children will have a lot of confidence in you. Show an interest. Number four, don't just go about sentimentally through the motion, because your children can detect this. Take an interest in their day-to-day affairs. Define a role of yourself. Number five, appreciate your children's effort. Appreciate any little effort your children make by themselves. For instance, when they dress up nicely, pass examination, etc. Appraise them. Number 6, listen to your children. You should listen to them and hear what they have to say. Learn about them by what they say to you. Correct them when necessary. Number 7, know your children's friends. When you think you don't like some of their friends, don't drive them as they may have an opportunity to interact at your absence. Instead, invite them to your house, monitor and study them, listen to them and instruct them. Number 8, teach your children. Don't let them get second-handed information or training from outside. Teach them good manners, honesty, respect, obedience, humility, and simplicity. Number 9, lead by example. Be good role model. Children are good imitators. They will copy everything they see you do. So live an exemplary life. Number 10, pray for your children. Speak to God with faith about the kind of children you want them to be. Pray for their goodness and never curse them. Because if you do, sooner or later it will actualize on them. Once again, my name is Favour Victor.